my niece was raised with my son. They're the exact same age, and I'm a single dad. My brother's a single dad, which, what does that tell you about the women we married? That we ended up with our own kids. It's like, wow, that rarely happens, especially to two guys. Anyway, this is where I decided that women are the most diabolical things on earth. My niece is 10, right? She's going on a trip with us, and she comes to me and goes, you know what? I think I'm old enough to pack my own bag. And I go, yeah, I think you are too. Go pack your own bag. You're a big girl. I don't care. So she packs her bag, throws it in a truck. We get to the first hotel, like, you know, several hundred miles. She opens her suitcase. All she'd packed were Beanie Babies. I just couldn't believe it. I walk into their room and she's putting them up. She's got like 30 of them, you know. And I go, I can't believe all you packed were Beanie Babies. You know, so now I put her back in the truck. We drive to Target. I get her all new clothes. We're coming back and I'm still making fun of her. I go, I can't believe all you packed were Beanie Babies. And she goes, I can't believe you just bought me all new clothes. And that's when I gave up on trying to outsmart women. Just like checkmate, first move. Like, really? You plan that at 10? I feel so sorry for the schmuck she marries. I really, truly do. Even my son didn't catch on until the end. He goes, wow. I wish I could think of something like that. I'm glad you can't. My kid calls me up. This was a couple weeks ago. I was on the road, and he goes, hey, Dad, the dog shit in the entryway. Should I clean that up? No, don't be a hero. You just leave it there. And go back in your room and play Warcraft or whatever the hell you were doing. Should I clean that up? No, I'll let it dry until it turns white, and then I'll vacuum it when I get home. Well, they're amazing. He doesn't need permission to take my motorcycle for 2 weeks at a time, but dog shit needs confirmation. Like I'm saving him or something, you know? Anytime I'm on the road and I pick up my cell phone and I see that he's calling, I go, oh no. Now what? Because one time he called me, he goes, hey Dad, where's the super glue? And I go, what broke? He goes, well, I ain't telling you. He goes, if you get home and can't figure it out, why the hell would I tell on myself? You know, and you start thinking, well, why can't you be that smart when it came to the dog shit, you know? And then he said something really smart. He goes, you know, super glue rarely works. He goes, why can't they make an adhesive that's like a Cheerio that's dried to a kitchen countertop? He said, yeah, you're right. You got to chisel that shit off. But yeah, they're just, they're amazing. Just, it's the younger ones. And I used to think that, you know, they were getting dumber just because maybe I was getting older and smarter. But no, they're actually getting dumber. And it's not their fault. It's because they have machines that do all their work for them. So they don't have to think about anything. I was at a convenience store once. I got a 20-ounce Coke. It was $1.05. I brought it up to the counter. I hand the kid $2. As he opens the till, I find a nickel in my pocket and I give it to him. Utter chaos. Oh my God, what is this? I don't think he'd have been more confused if I'd put a gun to his head. I go, you owe me $1. Didn't believe me, because the machine wasn't telling him that. So we had to have Brian come over, because he's 19. Honest to God, this whole thing took about 4.5 minutes. I thought there was going to be paperwork. I think the store would have been better off if I'd stolen the Coke. And after it was all done and I got my buck back, I don't think the kid still understood. I'll guarantee he was at a party later that night going, should have seen this old bastard today trying to get a Coke for a nickel. It's not the Civil War anymore, Grandpa. Oh, here's my nickel.